Hey guys, my name is Corey. This is the second of three videos showcasing voxels in the Godot game engine. Today we start looking at smooth voxels. If you recall from the last video, this terrain is generated by custom code, specifically a sine wave. And before recording, I went through and manually dug this tunnel. But if you provide your own code to procedurally generate the terrain, then you can make it look however you want. The terrain here is generated by a height map, the same height map we saw on the blocky voxel terrain in the last video. Here's what the height map looks like. It's just a flat 2D grayscale image. And since it's 2D, there's no way to define overhangs or tunnels, so that's why the option for custom code is important. You can see how the 3D terrain features match up with the 2D map. The backend is a C++ module for Godot, written by Zylann, aka Mark Gillerin, and I made the game demo we were watching. You can create your own height maps in Photoshop or Krita. Or you can find them online. This website, terrain.party, allows you to generate a height map based on real map data. Here's an area just outside of Tampere in Finland. I'm adjusting the levels so the brightest point aligns with white and the darkest aligns with black, then converting it from 16-bit to 8-bit to avoid wasting space. I got the best results when I blurred the height map by around 5 to 10 pixels. Otherwise, the meshing algorithm doesn't make very attractive terrains. You can see in the corner it produces many sharp and spiky pillars. If you're interested in how smooth mesh generation works, look up isometric surface extraction algorithms. The specific one used here is called dual marching cubes. Voxel Tools currently provides two nodes in Godot. The original voxel terrain supports either blocky or smooth voxels. Zylann is developing a new node called Voxel LOD Terrain. LOD stands for levels of detail. It's about 4 to 10 times faster and allows for a significantly greater view distance. Here I've turned on Godot's fog effect to make the background landscape look distant. The ability to edit the terrain has not yet been implemented. And the infinite paging system is being worked on as this video is being recorded. I've added a plane with a basic water shader on top for a nicer effect. That's going to do it for this video. In the next one, I'll take you to a very strange voxel world. This is my favorite type of terrain, a landscape generated by a 3D noise algorithm, complete with overhangs, bridges, caves, tunnels, and floating islands. If you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate a like and a share. Let me know what you think about smooth voxel landscapes in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and follow me on YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook so you can catch my next videos. Take care, guys.